The Medicare Open Enrollment period is a specific time of year where you can make changes to your Medicare coverage. But it's important to know when this time of year is and what changes you can make during this period. Today, I'm going to discuss the major factors involved in the open enrollment period. And this is really important to know if you're enrolled in Medicare. So stay tuned. Hi, I'm Jamie Banner, and I'm the founder of Medicare by Jamie. I'm a licensed insurance agent that works specifically with people enrolling into Medicare, and today I'm going to talk to you about the Medicare Open Enrollment, also known as the annual election period. So this is a specific time of year where you can make some changes to your Medicare coverage, but it does not affect everyone, and it does not affect every Medicare plan you could possibly have. So it's important to know if it affects you and what steps you need to take to make some changes to your Medicare coverage. Before we get started, if you find the information in this video helpful, I'd appreciate it if you would give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Leave a comment down below. It helps get this information out to more people so everyone understands exactly what this time period is. So when we talk about Medicare open enrollment, it's important to understand the who's, the when's, and the what's. So who this affects, when you can make these changes, and what changes you can actually make. So let's start to figure out if it even affects you. So who's affected by the open enrollment period or the annual election period? And that's going to be people who are already enrolled in Medicare. So these are people who already have their red, white, and blue cards and have maybe a Medicare Supplement Plan, Medicare Advantage Plan, or Prescription Drug Plan. These are all people that can make changes during the open enrollment period. However, if you're not already enrolled in Medicare, so you are initially enrolling, whether you're turning 65 or leaving employer group coverage, you are not currently affected by open enrollment period in the sense that you don't have to wait until this time period to initiate your Medicare enrollment. As long as you are turning 65 or leaving active, credible group coverage, you can start that initially. And this open enrollment period doesn't affect you at first. You don't have to wait. You can do it immediately for your Medicare enrollment. Now the when. When is this time period? It is every year from October 15th to December 7th. So toward the end of the year, you've got about a 2-month period to make all these changes. And it's the same every year. And this is really important to know exactly when this is happening. And a good thing to remember is even if you make the change October 15th, you are ready to make it, your new plans aren't going to go into effect October 16th or even November 1st. Everything goes into effect January 1st. So essentially, this time period starts at the end of the year to get you set up for the first of the year of the next year and start the next year on a clean slate. So like I said, even if you make the changes anytime between October 15th to December 7th, everything will take effect January 1st of the next year. So now we know who can make changes and when to make changes. What changes can you make? And the first one's going to involve a Medicare Advantage plan. So during open enrollment, you can enroll in a Medicare Advantage plan, change your Medicare Advantage plan, or disenroll from a Medicare Advantage plan. So these are the three things you can do with Advantage plans. You can start a new one, change the current one you have if you don't like it, or even leave your plan and go into something like a Medicare Supplement Plan. This is the time of year where you can make changes to your Medicare Advantage plans because you can't make these changes with Advantage plans all year long. This is the time period, so it's really important to, if you're gonna make these changes, know that October 15th to December 7th is your time frame to do this. The other thing you can change during this time period is a prescription drug plan. So again, you can enroll in one, even if you had never done it in the past. You can change your prescription drug plan, or you can disenroll from your prescription drug plan. And this is something I think is very important to assess on an annual basis, especially if you've been prescribed some new medications, maybe stopped taking some medications, or even if your list is the same, it's important to see, has your plan changed its coverage? Or has another plan come out with better coverage of your same prescriptions that maybe wasn't there last year? It's always good to make sure you have the best and most cost-efficient plan for your prescriptions because things can really change on a year-to-year basis. Now, if you like your Advantage plan or you like your prescription drug plan, you don't have to re-enroll every year. The only time that you would not be able to keep your current plan is if that plan was discontinued, and you will get formal notification in the mail prior to the annual election period letting you know that you have to set up a new plan. Who's not affected by this? People on Medicare supplement plans. So if you are currently in a Medicare supplement plan and you want to change that Medicare supplement to maybe another plan with more coverage, less coverage, you're not affected by this open enrollment period. The only difference is you have to pass medical underwriting. And I have a whole video that explains how medical underwriting works. I'm going to link it down below. But what if maybe you're currently in a Medicare Advantage plan and you want to switch to a Medicare supplement plan? This would have to be done during open enrollment. So you would need to apply for a Medicare supplement plan, go through underwriting, and if you are approved, end your Medicare Advantage plan at the end of the year with your Medicare supplement plan starting January 1st. So you need to make sure if you're going to make this change, you do it early enough. And this is what I do. I assist people in finding the best Medicare supplements, whether you're initially enrolling into one or leaving your Advantage plan or even switching from supplement to supplement. Give me a call. My number is 833-65-JAMIE. Visit my website, medicarebyjamie.com. But supplement plans, like I said, not really affected by open enrollment unless you're coming off a Medicare Advantage plan. And what I think is the most important thing to remember, start early. Because, like I said, you've only got this short, about 2-month time period, and you're not the only person making a change, especially if you're going from Advantage plan to supplement plan. There are a ton of people making this change, and therefore this underwriting process can be slowed down because everyone's getting that app in early. So if you wait until December 1st, 2nd, 3rd, it's given a really finite period of time. You want to start this in October. Get it done. Get it out of the way. Beat the masses of people because, like I said, for a lot of people, this is the only time of year they can make these changes. So everything is very, very crazy and busy. So my best piece of advice, start as early as possible. If you're thinking you want to make this switch, start thinking about it August, September, so you're ready in October to make that change, get it submitted, you know exactly what you want. Hope you found the information in this video helpful. Like I said, the open enrollment period affects a lot of people, but does not affect everyone. And it's really important to know if it affects you specifically. If you have any questions, you can always give me a call. My number is 833-65-JAMIE, or you can visit my website, medicarebyjamie.com. Like I said, I assist people with finding the very best Medicare supplement plans. It's no cost to you. You can visit my website, request a free Medicare supplement plan quote, and I'll go over everything with you and how to apply for one or even switch one. If you like the information in this video, I'd appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up and subscribe and leave a comment down below. If you stay tuned, I'm going to give you a tour of my website and show you exactly how to request that free Medicare supplement plan quote, as well as show you all the free resources and guides I have available for you. Again, thank you so much for watching. Hi, I'm Jamie Banner, the founder of Medicare by Jamie. I'm going to give you a quick run through of my website so you can easily navigate and find all the important links and information I provided for you. So when we get started, we're going to be right on the homepage, and the first thing you can see is you can request a Medicare supplement plan quote. And that's what I do. I assist people in finding the best Medicare supplement plan options for them. So if you go ahead and put your zip code in there and a couple other basic pieces of information, I can get you the best supplement plan quote in your area. Once we get away from there and we go up to the top, we can see the Resource Center. So if we click on the Resource Center, we've got a couple options under there. The first one's going to be Video Library. So when we click there, it's going to take you to a page that shows you all of my YouTube videos. So all my videos will be on there along with their titles, so you can easily kind of search through them and see what video you're looking for based on your current needs. There's also a button up there that says subscribe to YouTube. So that will take you straight to my YouTube channel where you can subscribe, comment, do whatever you need, and find all the videos you need. When we go back to the Resource Center, the next link is going to say Important Links. And that's going to be a ton of different hyperlinks that give a lot of information like finding doctors that take Medicare, maybe filing a claim if you had something, lots of different things that can take you out to show you things you can do for Medicare. And the last section is going to be guides and forms. Now, this one is really important. I've listed a ton of forms that are going to be very important for Medicare. Stuff like employer coverage forms if you're still working past 65, IRMA appeal forms, maybe if you need to check your Part B premium based on your income. I have all of that here, plus a lot of different informative PDFs that's going to give you as much information as you need in Medicare, because that's what we want. We want you to be completely educated on everything Medicare related so you can make the best and most informed decision. I've also got it up here where everything is divided into categories. So if you need to find something a little bit faster, just click one of these categories and it's going to narrow it down to things involved in that section. Again, if you have any questions, you can always call me. My number is 833-65-JAMIE. You can also email me at jamie@medicarebyjamie.com, or you can go to the website and hit the contact us button and you can send me a little information. I hope you found this video helpful and thank you for watching.